Hi, everybody. I'm excited to be with you guys today to talk about creating desire for InnerSource in the middle. So I am a communication strategist. I am an executive and business professional coach, as well as driving change initiatives like InnerSource and open source adoption within organizations. So why the middle? Why are we talking about the middle? In the 1980s, the CEO of General Motors coined the term the frozen middle. And he used this term to describe middle management because he found a lot of complacency there due to past successes. He found resistance to change, a lower desire to adapt to new challenges or advance. And a little more than 40 years later, we're still looking at the same struggle. The State of InnerSource report that Claire Dillon puts together has identified that the lack of middle management is a leading obstacle for InnerSource adoption. And that has been consistent for several years now. ProSci, which is a leading research institution for change management across the globe, it started in the late 80s, interestingly, from an engineer out of Bell Labs, has been doing research around this many, many years, and middle management has been identified as the most resistant group to change initiatives like InnerSource. I think that the stat is really interesting in that 43% of the respondents said that over half of management resistance was avoidable. Over half. That's huge. And so in this moment, and thinking about that statistic, I want to invite you to take a moment here and think about what a 50% boost, just 50, what would a 50% boost in InnerSource participation mean to your company? How would it impact your company? Some of you, you may be thinking about metrics. You may be thinking about contributions. You may be thinking about like ambassadors, as Sally just mentioned, her ambassador program. You may be thinking about ways that it would come alive more and come off the pages and be more relevant to business impact. And I want to invite you to write those, to capture those thoughts, to capture what that would look like for your organization, because each and every one of those is a metric. It is a story. It is an artifact. It is information that tells the difference that InnerSource is making both to you personally, but to your business. And so let's take a look at a day in the life of middle management and think about what that looks like. So the life of middle management is tough, right? It's tough. It is context shifting. So navigating dynamic interpersonal relationships. On the one hand, they will spend time deferring to senior leaders within the organization. On the other hand, they will be talking with their team and asserting their own leadership in the organization, or they are working collaboratively with a group of peers. That's a lot of context and role shifting and approach shifting based upon stakeholders. They are right in the middle of significantly conflicting demands, right? They're responsible for a team that has a lot of frontline concerns and obstacles that they will run into. And they likewise are talking with senior leaders who are sending strategy down and saying, you need to come up with a plan and we need to see this strategy come alive. We need to capture these beautiful ROIs that we have planned for our corporation. And so they are caught in the middle. They can often be barriers to communication because they don't know how to convey that message to the team, or aligning when there's been confusion around certain messaging. They can be responsible for the team morale, keeping the team morale high when they don't necessarily have the answers and what that might look like for them. So there's a lot of stressors that middle managers have, and it's important to consider this and be aware of this when you're looking at middle management. Now, each middle manager has their own special blend of what is most important to them. And that is something to keep in mind, because your message is going to be different depending upon who you're talking to. Remember that each middle manager used to be a subject matter expert, right? They were promoted into this middle management role. And as you get promoted up, organizations are not necessarily great at equipping people as they promote up to be able to convey messages that are important or be able to navigate the new demands that that role has. So going from an SME to someone who is responsible for communicating across the organization, who's responsible for being a liaison between different parties and different groups, who's responsible for advocating for the change initiatives that they're driving, they're responsible for resistance management, they're responsible for coaching the people on their team. Those are new roles and new challenges that they face. And I've spent a great deal of time sitting and talking with you about the challenges because this is where. When you understand their challenges, what they're looking at, and what the difficulty they face is, you will be able to answer a very, very important question. And the answer to this question is where you find the beginning of desire. And that is, what's in it for me? We've all probably heard of the WIFM. What's in it for me? What is in it for this particular middle manager? What is the impact that InnerSource is going to have for them and what they're trying to achieve? Because it is an individual answer for everyone. I know why I am so pro InnerSource and supporting this, and I'm sure you do as well. They may not have that answer. And if they cannot find that answer, they will not want to help drive this change. And so we can work at helping them drive and support this change. We can help them find this answer. But that answer must be found because it is the basis of having the desire to adopt InnerSource practices within an organization. And it can't be skipped over because if you skip over desire, what you see is higher turnover, you see lower productivity overall in organizations. And nobody wants those things, right? We're trying to get to adoption because with adoption comes the full ROI that InnerSource promises organizations. So once you have this answer, there are a couple strategies and things that I recommend in order to support the middle manager. The first is know the people. The second is support learning. And the third is align incentives. So let's talk about knowing the people. A lot of organizations really overemphasize project management, program management, and we're going to have a roadmap and milestones and KPIs, and we're going to all get through all of this. And those are great. They're great. But they do not tell you one of the most important facets of getting success in a change initiative, and that is people. You're dead in the water without people. Everything starts and stops with people. And so, doing a stakeholder mapping exercise where you understand who's involved. You've talked to the people. What are their expectations? What are their needs? Where have things failed before? What are the problems? Having these conversations, knowing who's involved, who's ancillary, who's around, who is above the project, who's below the project, who's over three levels, understanding who your stakeholders are and who you're trying to get adoption from is critical. And you cannot spend enough time doing this because it is the people who are going to drive the success of your InnerSource program. Know the people. Like I was mentioning when we talked about project management or program management, we talk about project and program management, but we don't also talk about change management. Change management is the people side of a program. And it is the people side that often gets left behind, right? Well, we gave you the roadmap. Why isn't everyone moving? We really need to spend some time thinking about change management practices and how we can equip people. The human infrastructure to make the change is critical to the success of InnerSource. So that might be something to look at coaching conversations. So Brittany Estenas talked earlier about empathetic coaching. It was a brilliant session. If you didn't watch it, I recommend you go back and do it. This is exactly what that is. It is having conversations with people and talking through the problems. It's sitting in and opening up a space where you can just have a dialogue to problem solve together and taking the time to do that. So you can't really help to drive desire if you don't know the people. And whether you are above the middle manager or you're below the middle manager, knowing the people and equipping them with the information necessary and providing that to try and bring people together as you move forward through your InnerSource journey is vital. Let's talk about support learning. Another big block that middle managers have is they don't have the knowledge. Well, thanks to InnerSource Commons, there is a ton of knowledge. In track one, Katie is speaking about documentation. This is huge. She's awesome. So it's a great speech. You should listen to her as well if you're in here with me. But the InnerSource Commons has all kinds of information. So there's the learning path. If you go to InnerSource Commons, I think it's / learn, there's research, there's the learning path, there's the patterns, there's a ton of information. If you don't know where to start, the patterns has this map that will identify certain problems so you can find exactly what you need and learn from what's already known. What are the best practices? Additionally, tomorrow, Isabel is doing a workshop on patterns where you can walk through it and look at how those things play. Highly recommend you participate in that. It's just wonderful opportunity to get familiarized with patterns and be able to contribute back. The next thing that we have is community calls. There are over 200 videos. We do this on a monthly basis. People are coming together to share real case studies of what they're doing and how they're using InnerSource within their organization. What are those impacts? This is incredible information in terms of strategies, tactics, where people are running into problems. It also gives you people's names. You can talk to them. You know, one of the most powerful ways to get education and continue to learn is to knowledge share, to have conversations and share it with peers and build new peers. Middle managers often feel very isolated in their position because they're dead in the middle. They don't necessarily belong to the different groups. And so having our Slack community, it's an incredible community. It's my favorite personal community that I belong to. There's all kinds of channels. Lori is the community manager there, and she can help you find the right channel to connect with the people that you want. So look at our Slack, join our Slack, get involved, ask questions. I've never run into anyone who said, I just don't want to talk to you. Very welcoming, lots of information is available. Please look at what is available. And if you have questions, reach out to me. I'm happy to guide through that. Lastly, you need to align incentives. So your business strategy, your business goals, your organization's business goals, from your business goals, you should align your InnerSource program. It should answer a specific business goal. Those two need to be aligned. And within your InnerSource program, there are activities that you're looking to have people do, right? And you want to reinforce those specific behaviors with incentives. So you're aligning from your business goals to your InnerSource program to the behavior changes that you're looking to have people make. And you can do that in a number of ways. We're all familiar with different rewards and incentives, whether you're looking at monetary benefits, you're looking at team events, you are looking at corporate awards, you have peer-to-peer kudos sites where people capture what, you know, how someone worked and how great they were. There's a lot of different ways to incentivize new behaviors to drive the adoption for InnerSource. In conclusion, I want to just go back to the beginning. Understand that middle managers are in a really pressurized spot. And just like us, they have strengths and weaknesses. And there's a lot of pressure. So it is important to consider for middle managers what problem InnerSource is solving for them. What is in it for them? What are you going to solve? What challenge does InnerSource better for them personally? It all starts with what's in it for me, for the middle manager. It is the foundation of creating that desire. And from there, you can help them know who the people are, uncover different challenges and risks, identify and manage the risks and resistance that you are going to find. You do find places. And the more you know, the more you understand the people, the better you're going to be able to navigate that and support middle managers. Or be a middle manager who does who's able to move faster, or support your direct report as they're trying to manage, right? There's a number of ways, and we can all kind of come together and understanding who these people are and supporting what challenges we're going to face so we can navigate them together. Don't think you're alone. There's a lot of information out there. InnerSource Commons is an excellent place to get all the information you can get. Our Slack channel, there are friendly people who are going through similar challenges that you can talk to, and make sure that as you do this, you're working at aligning your incentives from your business goals all the way through to the new behaviors you're looking to achieve. So with that, I will stop.